Hi everyone, today we are going to learn another question, which is merge intervals. In this question, we are given an array of intervals and we have to merge only overlapping intervals and return the array of non-overlapping intervals that cover all the intervals in the input. So the intervals array is given as this: 1,3, 2,6, 8,10 and 15,80. So we have to merge all the overlapping intervals. See, 2 comes between 1,3. So this interval will be the starting of the first interval and the ending of the second interval. That is 1,6. And these intervals will be like it is, because nothing comes between these two intervals. Like this 2 is coming in between the first interval. So we have to merge it. Merge the overlapping intervals. And in the second example, 4 is common in both. So we have to merge the overlapping part and the output will be 1,5. Like this, we have to do it for the whole array. I'll explain you more. Suppose this is another array. 1,3, 2,5. So 2 comes between 1 and 3. So the interval will be 1 and 5. Now 7,9, 8,11. So 8 is between 7 and 9. So the interval will be 7 and 11. And 12,15 as it is. So this will be the output. But there's one thing. Suppose the array is not given in the sorted order for the first interval. Like the first part of the interval is not sorted. So suppose we are checking for this 1,3 and 7,9. Nothing is in between the intervals. So we'll move forward 7,9 and 2,5. But we have traversed this 1,3. So it will be a problem, right? 2 is in between 1 and 3. So the interval should be 1,5. But it is not adjacent. And we cannot compare it. And same for like this also, 8,11. And we have traversed 7,9. So we cannot compare for these two. Because 2,5 is in between. So the thing is, we have to sort the intervals first. And then we have to compare. Because we have to compare the adjacent intervals. Then only we will be able to merge the overlapping intervals. Now let's see the code part. We are taking the vector merge. The intervals array is taken as the input. And we are taking an answer vector for the output. We have taken vector because we have to store it in the form of this array. You can also make it as a pair, which is also, there is the STL pair. You can study online how you can use pair, and I have used vector here because we have to store two numbers and we have to make an array of in which two numbers will be there. So we have written the if condition. If the size of the array is zero, so nothing is there to compare, right? So we have to return the answer. Then we have to sort the array intervals dot begin and the intervals dot end. This function will take log n time. Because this is a sort function, it will take log n time. Now, vector int first element interval. By this I mean the first number. I have stored the first number in this vector first element interval. And intervals is the name of the array. And first element of the interval, I have taken the first element of the interval array in a vector array named first element interval. See, interval of 0. This is 0 index and this is 1. The first element interval is this first index. Now I have run a loop and made a iterator named it_second. Because we are traversing the loop for the second. We are checking for the second one. Second index. We are checking for the second index in the intervals array. Intervals is the name of the array. And it underscore second is the iterator. Auto it underscore second is the iterator, which will travel the intervals array. If it underscore second 0, this will check the first index of the second one. Like we have, this is first one of the array and this is second. So it will check the second one. If it underscore second 0 is less than first element interval 1, this means, let's see for this, if this element is less than this, 2 is less than 3, then only it will be in between the first interval 1, 3. So this part we are checking here. If it underscore second 0, this means second array, second index of the array interval, second index of the array interval first element is less than the first element interval second. 1 is the second index, 0 is the first index and 1 is the second index. So we are comparing 2 and 3. If 2 is less than 3, then only it will come in between the interval. This is the meaning of this if statement. If it is lesser, then we have to merge the interval, right? So we will take the max of the it underscore first, max of this and this, 3 and 5. It underscore second first, that means 5. And first elements interval first. This is, I'll tell you again, 1, 3, 2 and 5. So the first element interval will be the max of the these both, max of these both, because you have to merge it, right? So it will be the maximum. 2 comes between 1 and 3. So the overlapping interval is 2. So we have to merge it. So the interval will be 1, 5, which will be the maximum of this index and this index, which is 5. So 1, 5 will be the output. This is the meaning of this statement. Else, if we are not able to find any overlapping interval, then we'll move forward. Like suppose 8, 11. We are not able to find any overlapping interval, so we'll push it into the answer and then we'll move forward. The answer dot push back first element interval. We'll push back it and then we'll change the iterator. Like if we are checking for 8, 11, we are not able to find any overlapping interval. Then we are pushing it into the answer and then we are changing it to the next index. This is the meaning of this statement, and then we are pushing it in the answer. That's it. We are pushing it into the answer and then we are returning the answer. Let's see the code part. This is the same thing I have written here. First, we are checking if the array intervals is 0 or not. If it is 0, then we have to return the answer. Then we have to sort the intervals, because if they are not sorted, we will not be able to compare them. And then we have taken the first element interval. Intervals is the name of the array, and first element interval is the vector that I have taken to store this first index. Interval array's first index 1. Then auto it second is the name of the iterator, which will iterate the intervals array and will check for the first element of the next index. If it underscore second 0, it underscore second will check for this index 0 part of this, that is 2. If 2 is less than 3, first element interval 1, this will check for 3. If 2 is less than 3, then we have to return the maximum of the 6 and 3. So 1 comma 6 will be in the output. We have to return the max of the first index of each array. This is 0th index and this is first index. So we have to return it. Else, if we are not able to find the overlapping interval, we have to return it into the answer. And then we have to change the iterator, because it will move, it will check for the next element. And then we have to return the answer. Let's submit it. The time and the space complexity of this code, I'll tell you. The time complexity is O of n log n. Log n for the sorting and n, because we are traversing the whole array. And space complexity is O of the answer vector that I have taken to store the answer. This is the space complexity. And time complexity is O of n log n. So that's it for today's video. Thank you.